I'm Emma from GoDaddy, and I'm reporting live from San Diego, California.
And I'm Darlene in sunny Arizona.
Many of you may be on week 3 or 4 of working away from others, either in your business or at home, trying to get things done. Darlene and I are completing much of our work virtually using Zoom, and we're going to cover the benefits of using virtual meetings for your business and how to run one. Let's get started.
When you can't do a face-to-face meeting, virtual meetups are the only way to connect. Sure, you can use a phone or email, but virtual meetups and meetings offer several benefits. So let's talk about the 4 main ones.
The first benefit is everyone is safe in their own home or apartment. No spreading of germs.
Secondly, you still get some degree of face-to-face interaction. So encourage everyone to pull out their webcam and use it.
Third, a meetup can keep you connected to your colleagues and your customers when you can't be in the same place. It gives you an opportunity to see people from faraway places, like us. Darlene and I are 350 miles apart, but we're here creating stuff for you who might be thousands of miles from us.
Lastly, virtual meetings and meetups tend to be focused. With a thought-out objective and agenda, your meetup has a purpose and something to focus on. That means you get what you need to get done in less time and no travel time.
So let's talk about how to set one up. 3 things are important for a successful virtual meetup.
1, you'll need a tool for getting everyone into a virtual room, something like Zoom or Microsoft Teams. Any application with seats, the ability to use webcams and audio, and the ability to screen share is helpful.
Totally. 2, you'll want a purpose to meet in a rough agenda. Introductions, purpose of the meeting, the outputs, and next steps. Keep it simple, keep it focused.
Right. And you'll want a facilitator to manage the agenda and keep things moving. Nothing more awkward than a virtual meetup and nobody is talking. So create that space for people to contribute and connect.
Follow these basics and you'll be ahead of the game. Then you can use your own virtual meetups to do all kinds of things like virtual happy hour or team building or client sessions like a virtual yoga class. I know I used it last night for my scary movie club.
We hope you found these steps for creating virtual meetups helpful. Once you get the basics in place, you can hack the format and do all kinds of things that'll be engaging for your meetup guests, customers, or whoever. I'm Darlene.
And I'm Emma. Stay safe.
And stay healthy.